For more than an hour, the governor painted a grim picture of Kentucky's continued fight against COVID-19. Overwhelmed hospital workers, ICUs filling up, and people younger and younger getting sick.
If you are unvaccinated, you are at the greatest risk that you have been since the very start of this pandemic.
Calling the Delta variant the most aggressive and deadliest form of the COVID-19 virus, Governor Andy Beshear pleaded with Kentuckians to get the shot. This as more children are being admitted to the ICU and hospitals, like King's Daughters Hospital in Ashland, which is at capacity.
Our COVID ICU is currently full, and we've opened a fourth COVID unit.
It's the same at St. Clair and Moorhead, according to the chief medical officer, who says his folks are hanging in there.
We have amazing nurses, we have amazing physicians, but they're really wearing out.
In just 6 weeks, Kentucky's numbers have jumped from about 1,000 cases a week to nearly 14,000. U of L Health is seeing four times as many patients compared to this time last month. And younger and healthier people are the ones getting sick.
Only around 50% of eligible Kentuckians have received the vaccine. It's just not good enough.
Nurses from the Thompson Hood Veterans Center, where 34 vets died in 2020 before vaccinations were available, urged anyone on the fence to make a move.
This time we have a weapon that we didn't have last year, that we prayed for last year, we dreamed of. The death and the pain is preventable.
Governor Beshear warned dire consequences will continue if more people don't get vaccinated.
There's a right thing and a wrong thing. Getting vaccinated, wearing a mask to protect each other is the right thing.
Right now, just over 2.3 million Kentuckians are vaccinated. That number jumped another 5,000 from Wednesday till today. Reporting in Frankfort tonight, I'm Lauren Adams, WLKY News.
And take a look at these numbers. From March 1st to August 11th, about 90% of COVID cases, hospitalizations, and deaths were among unvaccinated or partially vaccinated Kentuckians. Get the vaccine and you could score a free vacation. Once again, the governor is offering incentives to get the shot. This one is called Vax and Visit Kentucky. Beginning today, if you have at least one dose of the vaccine, you can register for a chance to win a safecation at one of Kentucky's 45 state parks.
In a recent study, 60% of travelers who came to Kentucky in 2020 reported that they viewed Kentucky as a safe destination.
The safecations include golf, lodging, and campground gift certificates. Winners will be selected weekly beginning on September 9th. We have a link to sign up to win on our website and the WLKY app.
Kentucky's Board of Education unanimously passed an emergency regulation today requiring masks in schools. The board met virtually, although a dozen protesters attended the meeting in person in Frankfort. The emergency regulation is similar to Governor Beshear's emergency order he signed on Tuesday, although Kentucky Education Commissioner Jason Glass says the state board has a different set of laws governing their authority over schools.
We felt strongly that the Board of Education had a legislative direction to create a regulation such as this if we felt like there was a concern around health and safety for our students, and so that's what they have done.
Attorney General Daniel Cameron has already challenged Beshear's executive order. Glass says that he expects the legal challenge against the board's emergency regulation as well. And for the second day in a row, a small group of parents gathered to protest the JCPS mask mandate. About a half dozen people held signs outside Van Hoos Education Center this morning. Yesterday, a slightly larger group protested outside the center. JCPS was the first district in our area and one of the first in the state to decide to require all students and staff wear masks, regardless of vaccine status.
New tonight at 6, 2 days after tweeting an expletive at a state senator, a Jefferson County Board of Education member resigns his leadership position. Chris Kolb responded to Whitney Westerfield's tweet questioning Governor Beshear's executive order on masks in school. Kolb confirmed that he will remain a member of the board as District 2's representative, which covers the Highlands. He's only stepping down from his vice chairman position. His resignation will be effective Tuesday at the board's next meeting.
The people serving you alcohol at a restaurant could soon get a little younger.
A pre-filed bill making its way to the Kentucky Senate floor would lower the age for servers from 20 in a day to 18. WLKY's Manoj Kungwari shares how the local businesses are reacting to the idea.
As the pandemic continues, you may see more signs like these, but Kentucky State Rep Richard White is working to change that, pre-filing a bill that local businesses say could play a huge role in getting them back to normal, as it would allow them to hire people for jobs they weren't previously eligible for. It's no secret the COVID-19 pandemic is affecting every industry in the state, but none more than hospitality. Drake's in St. Matthews is no exception. Managing partner Bob Cameron is trying to get back to his pre-pandemic staff. As of late, he's been successful at getting applicants, but there's just one problem.
It all comes down to, you know, the age of the applicant.
Being a venue that serves alcohol, they get a lot of people asking for beer and mixed drinks, but there are limited people who can serve them due to age.
And if you're not 20 in a day, I've got still positions available. But it gets to a point where we're starting to fill those positions.
And he's not alone. Venues all over the state are trying to combat the current age requirement, so much so that state lawmakers are deciding to step in. On Thursday, State Representative Richard White addressed the Interim Joint Committee on Licensing, Occupations, and Administrative Regulations with the solution.
I think if we could lower the age to serve alcohol to 18 years old.
A solution that would help out people like Cameron, but also one that district manager for Agave and Rye, Jason Fryman, says would help out those who get hired.
When I was 16, I started serving, but it was in a place that didn't sell alcohol. It made a huge difference that when I was actually able to serve alcohol, the amount of money that I was making.
Fryman says he's in favor of the move because, in his opinion, there's not much of a difference between someone who's 18 or 19 and someone who's 20 and a day.
As long as proper training is put into place, I think as long as you're 18, you're, you know, adult, you can do it.
And some lawmakers agree.
So we're talking about someone who's 18, over who's eligible for the draft, can go into service, is legally adult under the supervision of someone who's 21 serving tables.
Manoj Kumwari, WLKY News.
And if the bill is passed, it would also allow cashiers at stores who serve boxed alcohol to be 18 years old.
A lawsuit has been filed against LMPD on behalf of a man killed as well as several others injured in a fiery collision following a police chase. 22-year-old Trayvon Mitchell was killed in West Louisville on Tuesday, July 6th. LMPD says that officers were trying to pull over a black Ford sedan at Dr. W.J. Hodge Street when the driver took off. The driver crashed into a car, which ran over Mitchell on his moped and burst into flames. Mitchell's attorney says that surveillance footage shows the officer engaging in a high-speed chase with both his sirens and lights off. He says that they want stricter policies when it comes to police chases.
Some counties implement where if there's any type of pursuit, they have to stop the car and turn and go in the opposite direction. LMPD doesn't have it that strict.
LMPD does not comment on pending litigation. Tonight at 11, we'll hear from Mitchell's grandmother, who says her grandson was on his way to serving his country.
A Louisville man could get a death sentence if he's convicted of killing a 3-year-old girl and her father. Prosecutors say they're now seeking the death penalty against Kevon Lawless. Lawless is accused of killing 21-year-old Brandon Wattles and his daughter, Trinity Randolph, in August of last year. During a hearing today, a judge granted a request from Lawless's attorney to withdraw since it's now a death penalty case. But he said he would not postpone the trial.
Whoever takes this case, whether it's public defender, private counsel, the trial date will not be moved. So whoever's going to take this case needs to know that's the day, that's what they're signing up for, is to try this case in April. It will not be moved.
The judge also said since it's now a capital murder case, there will be a hearing every month until that April 15th trial date. No charges have been filed in a deadly shooting in the Fairdale area. Police say a man in his 30s was shot around 3:30 this morning on National Turnpike near the Outer Loop. Police say everyone who's believed to be involved is accounted for.
Police hope you can help them catch the driver who hit and killed a motorcyclist in Shively and then took off. It happened in the evening on August the 4th on Wathen Lane near 7th Street Road. Police say the driver went into the other lane while trying to pass a car and hit the motorcycle. Investigators have video surveillance from a nearby business that shows it was a black or dark colored 2016 to 2018 Chevy Malibu. It would be missing a passenger side mirror and have some damage to the body on that side. If you've seen this car or know the driver, call Shively Police. Southern Indiana police say a man carjacked a woman, pushing her out of the car and dragging her before leading police on a chase. It happened Wednesday afternoon when Columbus officers spotted David Compton, who was wanted on several felonies and driving a stolen car. When officers pulled the car over, they say he pushed the woman out of the driver's seat and took off. She suffered minor injuries when she was dragged a short distance. Police say that Compton crashed after a short chase in which he drove through stop signs and on sidewalks. Officers used a canine to find him. He was hiding in a trash can. They arrested him on multiple charges.
No more pool time. Why staffing and the pandemic forced a local aquatic center to end their season early.
Plus, protecting your newborn from COVID. New at 6, the recommendations for pregnant mothers and why local doctors say it's more urgent now than ever.
All right, listen, we worked through this evening. We're mainly dry out there. It's going to be hot. It's going to be humid, no doubt about it. But as we look ahead, there are some changes heading our way. We got a cold front that's going to work into town as we get into your Friday afternoon. That brings rain and storm chances back to the forecast, but also cools us off just in time for the weekend. We'll talk more about that forecast ahead coming up after the break.